Hi, in this tutorial we will talk about a tool, a very powerful tool that helps you create complex shapes. The tool is called Loft, and I will create multiple videos about this tool. In this first one I will talk about the basic features of this tool. So to use it, you need a path and cross sections, and Max will create a geometry along the path using these sections. So first I will create the path. I will use a grid snap just to create it from the origin up. It's not essential to do that, but I like to have my shape start from the ground up. So and the top viewport, I will create three circles with different sizes. Okay, now I will select the path from geometry, compound objects. I will click loft. Now since I want to use these circles as cross sections, I need to use the get shape option and keep the instance on. We will see why we need this instance thing. So here you have two ways to deal with the path. You can choose percentage, and 0% here means the beginning of the path, 100% means the end of the path. If you know the length of the of this line, you can also check this option and you can choose the distance. 0% means if I pick the cross section, Max will create an instance of the cross section and place it at the 0% location, and then extrude this shape upward until the end or the second cross section. Now let's do this in practice. So 0%, click get shape. I will choose the smaller circle. Max will create an instance of the circle and will put this instance based on the pivot point of the circle, which is here, it's in the middle. So the middle of the circle is at the beginning of the path, and the shape is extruded until the end. So now I will choose 100%, get shape, and I will choose this cross section, and now the geometry starts with this cross section, and then it morphs to blend with the other cross section. As you can see here, the loft is not linear. It takes the shape of it's kind of like having a busier thing. It starts to morph slowly, then speeds up, then ends up, you know, slowly. If you like to have it linear, you can go here and choose linear interpolation, as you can see now. I will leave it as the default for now. Now I will choose 50%, click get shape, and I will choose the bigger one. Also, notice that the subdivision, when you add, when I added the cross section here, the subdivision the number of polygons follows these values here. You can increase the subdivision in both directions, and these subdivisions happens between two cross sections. Before I added this one, it was 5x5 from here to here. Now when I added this one here, now the 5x5 is from here to here and from here to here. Now you might wonder that, okay, in this direction it is 5, but in this direction it's more than 5. Well, actually, because the circle is created with 4 arcs. If you look here, the first arc, it is 5. So it is following this division, this logic. So now let's try something else. Oh, before that, here you can uncheck cap end. Now it's opened from the end side, or you can choose cap start, or you can choose both if you like. Maybe you like to add a shell modifier to give it some thickness, for example. Okay, now let's say I want this cross section here to continue straight, let's say until the 10% of the path, and then start to morph. I can type here 10%, then get shape and choose the same cross section I used here. You can see also that the subdivision here, it's 5x5. Now I will type 90%, get shape, and I will choose the same cross section I used for the end part. For this one, I will type 60%, and I will type 40%. I will change the shading a little bit here. It looks better now. And now I will explain why I've chosen the instance option, because now, for example, I can pick this section. I can add an edit spline modifier, or I can convert this to editable spline. I will go to vertex. I will choose this vertex, for example, and I will move it. You can see I can choose this one also. So as you can see, you can create interesting forms using this tool. Now this is just the most basic features of this tool. In the next videos, we will talk about other features. And I will stop the video for now, and hope you like it and you learned something new. And if you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time. Thank you.